Twin Cities and Western's St. Paul Turn. The Twin Cities and Western Railroad operates a fleet of older EMDs, and of this, a lot of them are GP38-2s. They put on quite the show as they storm upgrade as they head back from St. Paul Yard towards Hopkins. The first train we'll see has three GP38-2s for power and is seen screaming up the BNSF Midway Sub. While the TC&W typically takes the BNSF's Midway or St. Paul subs, on occasion they'll also tackle Shortline Hill. Starting off at Merriam Park in St. Paul, we'll see the first section of this TC&W train slowly making its way towards the entrance of the Minnesota Commercials Yard. This St. Paul turn actually stalled as it came up Shortline Hill. It was a combination of slick rails due to rain and a lot of tonnage being pulled up grade. This is the first half of the train that stalled. Once these cars get put away into the Minnesota Commercials Yard, the train will then head back down Shortline Hill, tie on to the cars that are still sitting down by Chestnut Street, and bring them back up. This trackage is former Milwaukee Road. In its prime, it was a double track main with the track we see in the foreground referred to as the Third Short. This served a number of now long gone industries in the area. As the St. Paul Turn makes its way towards the Minnesota Commercials Yard, it passes the site of the former Amtrak Depot, which served the Twin Cities metro area until 2014. Amtrak now runs out of Union Depot, based in downtown St. Paul. St. Paul Turn makes a quick stop to line a switch and is quickly on their way again. After the TC&W set out the first half of their train in the Minnesota Commercials Yard, they cut off from their cars, pulled ahead, and started to head back down and towards Shortline Hill, light powered. Off in the distance, we can see the remaining cars for the TC&W to pick up on Shortline Hill. The crew of the St. Paul Turn slowly eases their power down Shortline Hill as they prepare to couple on and get the train moving again. Thank you. After the crew coupled back onto the remaining cars at the bottom of the hill, they performed an air test and were quickly back on their way, pulling the train back up Shortline Hill. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment below what you'd like to see in another video.